Installing swivel seats into a camper van conversion is potentially the easiest DIY project that you can do that also has the biggest effect of turning a cargo van into a camper. This project should only take you about an hour and a half and requires only the most basic of hand tools. Welcome to Explorist.life. My name is Nate, and I teach people how to build DIY campers. Let's get started. The swivels we are using are Scopima swivels from the Swivel Shop, which I'll leave a link to in the video description below. Now let's get into the boxes. There's a driver's side swivel and a passenger side swivel, and each is labeled on the sticker on top and comes with its own hardware. The swivels measure approximately 18.5 inches by 16.5 inches, weigh a shade over 32 pounds each, and are less than 1 inch thick, which means that they will add less than 1 inch to the sitting height of the seat. The levers that unlock the seats are on the front and push to the side to release the lock. Now let's get to work. We're going to start with a passenger seat, initially working up under the front of the seat. I grabbed a 7mm nut driver and loosened the screw on the most prominent electrical connection. Once that was loose, then I could pull the clip away for the wiring harness for the seat. There is also a retaining clip on the wiring harness that can be dislodged by simply pulling down. Now in a previous project I cut the zip tie on this as I didn't know it could just be pulled down, but it is what it is. Next was time to remove the bolts on the seat. There are simply 4 bolts to remove, one on each end of both of the seat rails. These are removed with a 10mm socket. I remove the bolts at the front of the seat rails and set those aside as they would not be reused. I slid the seat forward. I remove the bolts at the rear of the seat rails, and then removed the seat from the van, taking special care to make sure that the wiring harness was not caught on anything. To install the swivel, I put the passenger side swivel into place and pulled the wiring harness through the center of the swivel. Then I pulled the red lever to the side to slightly swivel the top part of the base out of the way. Then I gathered the 4 flathead machine screws from the swivel hardware kit. Then used a 5mm hex bit to fasten the swivel to the seat pedestal. Next, I could put the seat back into place and align the holes, and attach the seat rails to the swivel using the included bolt, washer, and nut. The child seat latch bar prevents the swivels from going all the way around, so that needs to be removed. This can be removed with a hacksaw, which took me about 6 minutes or so, or it can be removed with a multi-tool, which takes about 60 seconds, or probably less if the blade was actually sharp. Reciprocating saws, jigsaws, or pretty much anything else would work here. Just maybe refrain from using anything that throws sparks, like a grinder or a Dremel tool or anything like that, but you do you. Once that was out of the way, I could sand down the rough spots and paint with a dab of Rust-Oleum. Now the factory seat rails also hit the door while turning. Now this just seems like a it is what it is kind of thing due to the geometry of the factory seat, and if you wanted to trim this up a bit so it didn't hit, you could probably cut the backs off of the seat rails, but I'm a bit hesitant to cut OEM seat rails, so for now, we'll just be opening the door slightly, swiveling the seat, and then closing the door, easy peasy. But you've got options here on your own install. To finish the installation, we're just going to tighten up all of the remaining bolts and nuts. Turn the chair around, and slide it back so we can access the final 2 bolts. Then reconnect the electrical connection on the front of the seat and fasten it in place with the screw we disconnected at the start of the video. And lastly, reconnect the retaining clip if you didn't break it like I did. and the passenger seat is now finished, so let's move on to the driver's seat. Now the process here is very similar to the passenger seat, except for the wiring harness, but let's just rip through this process quickly, and we'll slow it down to show you anything new. We remove the electrical connection, the factory bolts, and the seat. And when we put the swivel in place, we found out that the electrical harness was too chunky to fit, so we had to make a modification here. Now Far Out Ride has a great fix for this in their blog post about this installation, and we're just going to mirror that. We made a mark in the plastic cover in the middle of the swivel, took a nut driver and removed the bar across the length of the seat pedestal, removed the plastic battery cover, used a step bit to drill a hole in the battery cover on the mark that we made previously, and then used a box knife to cut a slit from the hole to the back of the cover, pulled the wire through the slit into the new hole, replaced the metal bar and hardware, replaced the swivel and pulled the wiring harness through, swiveled it slightly to get the top part out of the way, inserted the new hardware, replaced the seat, inserted the new hardware to attach the swivel to the seat rails, and secured them with the bolts, washers, and nuts from the swivel seat kit, and tightened with an impact driver and wrench. Lastly, we reattached the electrical connection and tightened it back up. And that's it. About 3 hours of work, including all of the camera stuff that we had to do to make this video, and we had the swivels installed. Now, it took a minute to figure out the best position to have the seats in to get them to swivel, but the main takeaway here is that if you're over 6 foot tall, swiveling while sitting in the seat probably isn't going to work. The main gripe we had about the swivels in our old Sprinter was that it added too much height to our seats. Now, me being 6 foot two wasn't much of an issue, but Steph also isn't really short at 5'7", and the increased height actually made it so that her feet didn't even touch the floor when we were driving. These swivels are less than an inch tall, so that is a non-issue this time around, which is incredibly welcome.
Great. Got all that? Yep. We're good? We're done?
And that's all for this week, and I hope you found the video helpful. We'll see you next time.